Hello friends, this is Gokul Pai and today I'm going to talk about bailout packages, which is the most discussed topic in recent times. And it's a lot of money. US has announced around $2 trillion sometime back. And India this week announced 20 lakh crore rupees, which is around $265 billion. And we can expect more packages in coming days. So it's a lot of money. Ye paisa hai kaisa. So what is your feedback about the bailout packages and are you benefiting in any way out of it? Please leave your feedback in the comment section. Today I am going to talk about possible vulnerabilities, risk and required control measures to make the package successful. So if you see the package, most of the money is flowing through the banking system, which has the history and reputation of making bad loans. We have recently read about defaulters absconding and leaving the country and also banks making provisions and writing off huge amount of bad loans. Now the package in the form of government guarantees and also collateral free automatic loans is like an automatic license for banks to continue making bad loans. In addition, also the review process to validate potential borrowers is also with the banks. If you see, there is also huge amount of liquidity flowing into the non-banking financial companies, around 75,000 crores. NBFCs are like very important for economy because they cover those areas which traditional banks cannot go. But at the same time, recently NBFCs have been subject to poor corporate governance and bad management practices and frauds. If you remember, recent cases of Dewan Housing and ILFS are very good examples. In addition, before the money ultimately reaches the recipient, the system has so many intermediaries and actors and players involved, vested interests, lot of businessmen, local politicians, so which also increases the vulnerability. Also, right now, there is a real urgency to transfer money as soon as possible because the magnitude of this crisis requires urgent action and there is a need to transfer money as soon as possible, which gives very little time to think about other issues like control, which also increases the risk. So the package has a lot of money. So even a small leakage at some stage, it will be the magnitude of loss to the government will be huge, which will be very difficult later on, even if it is discovered through some audits. So what is required according to me is multiple oversight bodies just to monitor the use of these stimulus amounts. US, for instance, has constituted three core groups just to monitor these amounts. And despite that, there has been some criticism about lack of proper oversight over the use of the spending. And second, there has to be specific anti-corruption clauses inbuilt in the package itself. For instance, Transparency International has given a huge list of recommendations to US government. I have just picked few of them which are very much relevant everywhere. For instance, disclosure of beneficial ownership information, prohibiting any funds going to businesses owned by politicians and their family members. And the third point is very important, I've highlighted in yellow. That detailed report of how funds are allocated and making it public through the online portal. United Nations has also given a list of recommendations to all countries, including transparency, use of technology, identification of risk, and again, the last point I've highlighted, comprehensive audit, oversight, and accountability. So I think with increased oversight and transparency, the stimulus package will achieve its intended purpose and also reach the targeted beneficiaries. I would like to finish on a lighter note. There has been a joke about number of zeros which are there in these stimulus amounts. So I would like you all to listen to a song from an old Bollywood movie, Kurz, which is very much relevant to this topic. Enjoy the song and also carefully listen to its lyrics. And let's hope that in every country, all the money which is announced as stimulus amounts reaches the right audience. Thank you for watching. Stay safe. See you soon. Bye.
Hey, thanks, Coco. Actually, you spoke about a very relevant and important topic, which I think a lot of us sometimes don't think about. You hit on a lot of key points. I just hope the people who are in charge don't drop the ball. Instead, it would be great if they drop more bills like you did. And you know what? If that were to happen, most people would be thrilled. They may even start singing and dancing, like I'm about to do.
Pesa, pesa, pesa. पैसा ये पैसा